Okay, I had a comment from Mike PSI a couple days ago. He was looking for information about 41 Colt, like bullet molds. And I wasn't quite sure. I wasn't sure if NOE made them. He said they don't. So, anyways, I looked through my old Lyman Ideal handbook, 39. This one's from like 53, I think. And it has a section that shows a whole bunch of the bullets that Lyman or Ideal used to make. I think some of these were out of production even when this book was made, but it gives you a good starting point for to find some of these old molds. At least you can get the mold numbers. I'll focus there. It's got some glare. But here's the three that they list, and they're like these two are healed. And then this one is the expanding one. I think this one says for short, I think. And then the heavier ones are for the long. And there's the numbers here. 386, 176, 177, and 178. And it has the weights. And so both of the healed ones, this is their 403 diameter, and then the expanding one is 386, but so I think the expanding one is, I think it mentions in this book that it is actually easier to load, but because I think a lot of the Colt rounds back then, they were like the bullet and the case for the same size. They're kind of like a 22 long rifle kind of deal. There's a little bit of reloading data here for the long, I believe. Let's see. Yeah. That'll focus. Yeah, a little bit of data. So that's for the long. I'm not sure what cartridge he's dealing with, but anyway. Use it for what you want. I noticed some of the data in this book's a little bit wonky, so I'd maybe check it in other places to make sure some of these loads are safe. But it's using the healed 196 and then the hollow base, and then it mentions, 186 grain healed bullet and case diameter are both the same dimension, and then it says 200 grain hollow base. Depend on expansion to fill and seal barrel diameter. I forget where I saw it mentioned that the hollow base was easier to deal with, but maybe that was in Cards of the World. Anyway, so that's all this book really says, but that's probably more than most places. So, but it's not terrible ballistics, like 200 grain bullet one's going 880 feet per second apparently, so that's I think in Cards of the World it's sort of the 41 long Colt, it's sort of, they say it's similar to the 200 grain loading and the 38 special. That's sort of what it's similar to, but so anyway, so it's good to have in these old super old books that you can find a little bit of information about stuff that's, I think this one's 53, there's the date on it. Yeah, 1953. Huh. Anyway, book's getting a little bit in rough shape, but it's got lots of good information in it, so. Anyway, thanks for watching, I figured to do a little video about that to show those molds. If anybody else is interested, I don't know if there's much information on YouTube about 41 Colt. It's sort of a fairly scarce cartridge, I think, these days. But I guess it was quite popular in its day back in it came out late 1870s, something like that. So, later part of the 19th century, it was, I think, fairly popular. So, anyway, talk to you later.